I don't want to set the world on.
Let's see, are you a boy or a girl? It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. Our beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about... That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up. You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
James?
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions.
James.
Get the baby out of here. Move! Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
You want it. We need a doctor, not a deadbeat.
This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations
now,
and there will be
no... Don't look straight
James
into the light now.
James and his cheery
charity. Decorations.
A future bright
toys. This place will feel just like home. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to Daddy. There you go. My goodness. Just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo. I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
Mama.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
These experiments
don't be a damn fool. We experiment to prepare. We prepare to survive. Of course I miss it.
Surprise!
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Happy birthday! Your dad was a... You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess. Ha! I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak, issue 14, and with no missing pages. I found this in a box of my father's old things, believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What, are you two best friends now? Hey, Wally, I think Paul's gone soft on us.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amada put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason. Don't presume too much on her friendship, young man. I'm still the overseer, and I'm still in charge of this vault and everyone in it.
Yeah, Paul.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Fiddlesticks. What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
Can you introduce us to your new best friend?
Who do you mean, Dorkface here?
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
How's it going, pal?
Oh, no.
Allow me to...
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer. Mrs. Palmer said I didn't have to share. Who's talking about sharing, moron? I want the whole thing. Now, are you gonna give me that sweet roll, or am I gonna have to give you a knuckle sandwich? Oh, yeah?
Wish you a happy
You're gonna be
birthday.
Sorry, you little...
I would offer you a piece of cake, but,
Butch, what do you think you're doing? Leave him alone! You all right, son? He didn't hurt you, did he?
Come on.
I hope Butch didn't hurt you. Why, that little... I figured it was him that's... You let me...
What's Butch's problem, anyway? God, he really is a butthead. Oh, well. You can always count on Butch to make an ass of himself. Get it?
Daddy, I told you not to act
all
official.
Butch.
I know you were joking,
hey,
but I'm not sure anyone
Gomez.
Else did.
Nice
Nonsense.
Party, huh?
People always enjoy my
I've had it with
speeches.
You, Butch. Your mother
Besides,
is going to hear about this little incident.
A reminder that
Are you all right? Is Butch I wish we didn't have to invite him, but they're just... In any case, you'll have to learn to deal with bullies. The world is full of people much worse than Butch, I'm... But don't let him ruin your birthday. Go on. I bet there's someone else waiting to give you a present.
It is not all
so, what do you think we should call...
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday! Not much, but I hope you like it.
Call our gang. It's gotta be totally cute.
This is supposed to be a party, you know? Fun? You should try
Come
it sometime, Daddy. You might like it.
For now, just remember, I'm keeping my eye on you.
Nice party.
I don't know. Maybe.
Well, Happy birthday, Sonny!
I've gotta think about it. You guys
Thanks
are dumb.
Coming, Sam.
Somebody's gotta have a
I
better
know you
idea
were busy
than those.
With the water purifier. Everything's fine, I hope.
Jonas?
Oh, sure,
oh,
nothing to worry
really
about.
Does.
Me and Andy
awesome
got her all fixed up again last night. Good as new.
Thanks.
Allow me to wish you a happy birthday.
You can fix anything, right?
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I... Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead.
Cake.
Are you having a nice time?
Nice party.
How are you enjoying the party, Mrs. Palmer? I help with the decorations, you know.
Happy birthday, dearie. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem, just for you. I hope you like it. Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
Oh, really? They're lovely. You did such a splendid job.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Are you ready for your surprise? The overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? We sure can't, unless we want the overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on. Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas.
Happy birthday, buddy. I hope you have fun with it. Hey, you don't turn 10 every day.
Think you can take care of that with your BB gun? Just aim and shoot. Good work. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with the big game hunter.
Smile!
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is her problem
right?
Anyway? So, I'm the overseer's daughter,
Gloria.
So what?
That
like, I get any
Gloria.
Kind of special
Tell
treatment.
Me.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your GOAT exam. Go on now. You've got a GOAT to take. The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test, GOAT. Everyone here in the Vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the Overseer says? We're born in the Vault, we die in the Vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all Vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar? Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the GOAT. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. Take care, son.
Good morning. Hey, 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 sport.
Get
it's been a while
way, you
since you stopped
snakes.
In here to see us. It's the big goat day today, right?
Snake, Amada. God, Butch, why don't you...
Yeah? What do you want? None of your business, kid. Get out of here before you get hurt. If you mess with the tunnel snakes, you're asking... Like I'm gonna listen to a... And who are you... Keep talking like that... You've... Come on, tunnel...
Butch, stop it! Leave him alone!
Tough guy, huh?
Give him
Hit him again!
This isn't solving anything!
How do you like that, Poindexter?
This isn't solving anything!
Give him another one!
Stop it! This isn't solving anything!
I got
Teach
another
you
one
mess
just
with
like
the
that in my
snakes.
Other hand.
Nice Give one, Butch! Him another.
Careful
snakes.
With that.
This little bitch isn't worth... Okay, okay, you win. We'll leave the little girl alone. You're not worth our time anyway. Come on, Tunnel Snakes. We're out of here. Whatever you say, Butch.
Hi, Stanley.
You're the boss.
Sorry.
Tunnel Snakes
way.
Rule.
What seems to be...
Fine.
The
Let's go.
I've got this
hey,
headache.
Susie, what's new?
Oh, not... Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father is the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Our heater's on the fritz again.
You're kidding me. Didn't you just get new parts for it last week?
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through.
Remember, Vault 101.
I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck. I can run a few more tests. Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, "I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber." What's your response? Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do? Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do? Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer? Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another vault resident. What do you do? Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question seven. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Question eight. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number one. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it? Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants. They say the goat never lies. According to this, you're slated to be the next vault chaplain. God help us all. Yes, it's refreshing to see such, youthful enthusiasm. Good to know that the goat occasionally gets it right. You know what they say about monkeys and typewriters. Well, I'm glad things turned out so well for you. I hope your classmates find their results half as satisfying. I'll see you tomorrow, bright and early.
Anything is possible, even an egg.
Dad,
Mr. Brock
here to save you now. Is he helping me get back to work? So what are you going to do now? Selfish and insubordinate.
Look,
just
wake up!
You need
Come
to
on,
know
wake
those
up.
Things. I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here! Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you! He's left the vault! I don't know how, but he's gone, and my father, he's kind of gone crazy. I thought so too, but it's true. He's gone, and Jonas is dead, and now they're looking for you! I don't know! Some of my father's men? Look, that doesn't matter right now. You need to worry about getting out of here alive! Revenge will have to wait. Oh, so you don't trust me now? Thanks a lot. You think it was easy for me to get here, with the rad roaches and security all over the place? I understand. It must be rough, waking up suddenly to find your dad gone and everything turned upside down. Listen, it may not be any of my business, but didn't your dad tell you anything about his plans? Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan. Listen, there's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck! I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't wait for me.
There he is. Hold it right there.
Criminy, more roaches. Yeah!
There he is. Ha!
Blood.
Shouldn't have tried to run.
Oh! Oh!
Ow!
Oh!
No!
Gotta help me! My mom's trapped in there with the rad roaches! No, I can't go back in there. It's dark, and there's rad roaches. Oh my God! Thank you! I didn't know what to do! You're the best!
Stop it! Ow, that hurts!
you know? Come on, sit.
We did it! My mom's gonna be okay! You're the best friend I've ever had, man! Hey, I know it isn't much, but I want you to have my Tunnel Snakes jacket. Go ahead, take it.
Down and have a drink with me.
This is the overseer.
You're the best, man! The best! Everything's gonna be okay now, thanks to you.
Rad Roach infestation is under control. Do not interfere with vault security personnel. Any resident found outside his or her quarters will be dealt with severely. That is all.
What a mess. Oh, you're lucky it was me who found you. The others won't be so forgiving. I don't know what you're up to, and I don't want to know. Just clear out of here, and I'll pretend I never saw you. It's a real shame it's come to this. I can't believe what they did to Jonas. Officer Mack was just out of control. But you're a good kid. You didn't do anything to deserve this. Go find your dad if you can.
Young sir, how very good to see you.
You're the one everybody's looking for, right? Well, it's none of my business. Your dad always took good care of us.
Oh, come on. Pay more attention. What you're doing. Just hold still. Your left stabilizer's been knocked loose.
I am holding still. It's your old pulsing hand.
We can just go back to our quarters.
It's our only chance, don't you see? We're getting out of here, just like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us. It's me, Tom Holt.
Be careful!
Over here!
That's it. There he is!
Take him down!
I'm gonna be sorry!
The overseer won't tolerate this kind of behavior.
Blood!
You like that, you bastard?
reasonable, Amata. Officer Mac may enjoy this, but I don't. Just tell us where to find your friends so we can...
Gotcha now!
I hope you're here to turn yourself in. I place the good of the vault above everything, even my own paternal feelings. We must not allow sentiment to cloud our judgment. But I admire your protective instincts. Very well. I give you my word that Amata will not suffer further because of your actions. Now then, if you really care about Amata, you will see how dangerous your father's actions were. Hand over your weapons, and put an end to this dangerous situation. There is no need to join your father as a traitor to the vault. Thank you. That will make this...
There he is! You should have tried to run!
You're leaving. I guess you were trying to help me, but you... You didn't have to kill him! So you say. Maybe one day I'll be able to forgive you. But not now.
I hope you never have to find out what it's like to see your father killed right in front of you. No, don't listen to me. Just go. Find your father. I have to go bury mine. You'd better leave before I change my mind about letting you go.
Hold on, Jonas. I need to record this first. I don't really know how to tell you this. I hope you'll understand, but I know you might be angry. I thought about it for a long time, but in the end, I decided it was best for you not to know. So many things could have gone wrong, and there's really no telling how the Overseer will react when he finds out. It's best if he can blame everything on me. Obviously, you already know that I'm gone. It was something I needed to do. You're an adult now. You're ready to be on your own. Maybe someday things will change and we can see each other again. I can't tell you why I left or where I'm going. I don't want you to follow me. God knows life in the vault isn't perfect, but at least you'll be safe. Just knowing that will be enough to keep me going.
Don't mean to rush you, Doc, but I'd feel better if we got this over with.
Okay, go ahead. Goodbye. I love you.
I'll be there. Another newcomer. Name's Lucas Sims, town sheriff, and mayor too, when the need arises. I don't know why, but I like you, boy. Something tells me you're all right. So welcome to Megaton. Just holler if you need something. Friendly and well-mannered.
I think we're gonna get along just fine. You treat my people nice, and you're welcome to stay as long as you'd like. I'm glad we understand each other. Now, is there something I can help you with? Nope. Sorry. I got enough fires to put out in this place that I don't have time to keep tabs on every visitor. I'd ask around town. What about it? I don't trust any of the locals to tinker with it. Besides, most people don't even realize it's still a threat. And hell, Cromwell and those crazies from the Church of Adam, they worship the damn thing. Why? You think you got the know-how to disarm it? For good? Oh, all right. Fine. But listen here. Just take a look at it first. Go easy. If you get the job done, there'll be 100 caps in it for you. Well, that's mighty decent of you. Just don't, you know, go blowing us up, all right? Sure thing, partner. What do you need to find? You'll probably want to see Moira at Craterside Supply. She sells some weapons. Makes some too, from what I hear. Her place is down by the crater. Have a good...
It's locked for a reason. Don't get any ideas. I hear you're that stray from the vault. Oh, I haven't seen one of you for years. Good to meet you. I'm Moira Brown. I run Craterside Supply. But what I really do is mostly tinkering and research. Say, I'm working on a book about the wasteland. It'd be great to have the foreword by a vault dweller. Help me out, would you? Great! Just tell me what it's like to live underground all your life. Yeah, you wouldn't imagine how hard it is to replace that big light bulb up there, too. That's great for a foreword. Open with a joke and all that. Here, take the suit. Something tells me you might need it. That'll be good for the book. In fact, want to help me with the research? I can pay you, and it'll be fun. Well, it's a dangerous place out there in the wastes, right? People could really use a compilation of good advice, like a wasteland survival guide. For that, I need an assistant to test my theories. I wouldn't want anyone to get hurt because of a mistake. Nobody's ever happy when that happens. No, then they just yell a lot at me with mean words. Good enthusiasm! Now, I think the first chapter will have to be about surviving day-to-day dangers. Things like where it is and isn't safe to find food, the dangers of radiation, and how to avoid and even profit from dangerous landmines. Ooh, sounds like fun, doesn't it? Which do you want to do first? Well, food and medicine. Everyone needs them once in a while, right? So they need a good place to find them. There's an old super-duper mart not far from here. I need to know if a place like that still has any food or medicine left in it. Oh, great! Food is most important, but see if you can get medicine too. And if there's nothing to find, then just come back in one piece, okay? good hunting. Could be the guy I saw at Moriarty's saloon not too long ago. I'd ask there.
Hello?
some things we should talk about, if that's all right. Did you know...
Those monsters...
There are those amongst us who would shatter our hopes for peace,
things.
Order, and security. These radical malcontents...
You look stronger than all the other...
You. They don't care about America!
Those
all they care
big
about
things.
Is fulfilling...
Please.
Their own selfish
My
desires.
House is the one closest
Let's
to the huge sign and the old diner.
Agitators,
Please,
shall we?
Find my papa and make him come back.
Those anarchistic ruffians who roam the wastes, preying on any and
Well,
all
there is the personal shelter.
Murdering.
Papa always said to stay away from it.
Brotherhood of
but
Steel.
I'll head over
Don't
there and
be
wait.
Fooled by their pseudo-knightly nonsense or supposed connections to the United States Army. These power-armed Boy Scouts are nothing more than common criminals with access to some antiquated technology. Criminals who have had the audacity to claim this country's most
stupid monsters. Can't get me in here. Come on, tell me already. I guess I already knew. Besides, I'm too tired to cry anymore. You gotta stop it, so this can't happen to anyone else's family ever again. I wish I had met you a long time ago, and then maybe my dad would still be alive. Thanks for doing all this. I'm feeling better now that you're here. Be careful!
Want something?
Making a move? Yeah, look. Another one of you wasteland assholes. Look here, asshole. I don't like you. Stay clear of me and we'll have no trouble. Come back if you need something.
Hello.
Come on, you piece of junk.
Hello.
Colin Moriarty, at your service. Welcome to Moriarty's. My saloon, my home. My slice of heaven in this backwoods little burg. If you've got the caps, I've got your pleasure. Please sit down, make yourself comfortable. Your troubles are a thing of the past. My God, it's you. The little baby boy all grown up. Persistent little bastard, ain't ya? Then and now, it would seem. It's been a long time, kid. Oh, your daddy passed through here all right. Here and gone. Got what he came for and then left. I'm assuming you'll do the same, correct? Is that what your father told you? That you were born in that hole? That he was born there as well? Oh, the lies we tell to those we love. Your father brought you to the vault right after you were born. To keep you safe, you see. I remember it well, you stayed in my saloon after all. That's right. Your father, his Brotherhood of Steel friend, and you, the suckling babe with nary a tit to suckle. Sorry about your mom, truly. But life goes on. Daddy lied. Life's full of little disappointments. And now you're all grown up and wondering where he's gone to. Ah, I see. You know, I heard about the brainwashing that goes on down there. From some other fella, escaped. Oh, 5 years back. All hail the Overseer. We're born in the vault, we die in the vault, and all that other assorted lunacy. Kid, you've got better programming than our own Deputy Weld. You'd best wise up quick. Wouldn't want anyone taking advantage of you, hmm? You seem like a nice kid, so I'm going to be straight with you. Your dad was here, and now he's not. And yes, I know where he went. But what you're asking me for is information, and information is a commodity. Let's say 100 cops, and Daddy's location is yours. Very reasonable. All right, kid. Let me help you out. You know, for all time's sake. If you don't have the cops to pay for the information, then maybe you could do a little favor for me. Eager, eh? Good. I like that. It's nice to have a door in this shithole of a town for a change. This junky bitch named Silver borrowed quite a few caps from me. Claimed she could start funneling Jet and Psycho to me for a good price. Problem is, she scrammed with the loot and set herself up in Springvale so she can inject herself into a stupor. Get the caps she owes me and they're yours. Yours to pay me with, anyway. Careful in DC now. Those super mutants can...
It's the same damn thing.
I told you, Gob, it ain't hey. The radio. The Enclave station comes in...
I'm not supposed to talk to strangers.
What?
Don't try anything.
I don't think that belongs to you.
So, how's this?
Thank you.
Good hunting!
Welcome to Megaton.
I give up. You're not getting any more fixed with me just talking to you.
Lawnmower in need of maintenance. Please repair.
Thank you.
Loading personality. Robco, R04B9. Office helper. Running default office protocol. Air or loading daily agenda. Air order. Security breach detected. Please stand back. Greetings, fellow office employee. Please present your valid ID. Warning, scan failure. Please present ID for exit of building.
Go time! Stop moving around so much!
This is gonna be fun!
getting any...
Don't mind the smell. I was just testing a few chemicals. But it's perfectly safe to breathe. So, how's this? Really? You did? Whoa, really? Raiders and robots? I guess I wasn't the only one to think about checking those stores. Looks like you gotta be careful looting them. Well, keep what you got. Just traded for a big food shipment myself. Here, take a bit. My treat. Tastes kinda grates after a while. Oh, and take this. It's an old food sanitizer. Just carry it with you, and it should automatically make most food and drink, better. I still need to study a living specimen with radiation poisoning. I need someone to research how to travel through a minefield. And that'll cover the first section of the book. Which strikes your fancy? Well, that's what I need your help for, isn't it? I know lots about it from books, but I never seem to get a live example. Not for long, anyway. So I need you to get a bit of radiation poisoning, so I can study its effect. Oh, not a deadly dose, of course. I can fix you up before that. Oh, you're a peach! Or at least some sort of hardy fruit that grows in the savagely irradiated mockery of agriculture we have nowadays. Now, 200 rads should be enough for basic sickness. But if you can get 600 or more rads, my test will be even more accurate. Just make sure you can get back here, and I'll see to it that you're well taken care of. Take care.
Those who dwell here in his favored land, attend now to the words of the prophet of Atom. Come forth and drink the waters of the globe, for this ancient weapon of war is our salvation. It is the very symbol of Atom's glory. Let it serve as a reminder of the division that has occurred in the past, and the resplendence of the promise of our division in the times to come. Give your... bodies to Atom, my friend. Release yourself to his power. Feel his glow and be divided. There shall be no tears, no sorrows, no suffering. For in the division, we shall see our release from the pain and hardships of this world. Yea, your suffering shall exist no longer. It shall be washed away in Atom's glow, burned from you in the fire of his brilliance. Each of us shall give birth to a billion stars formed from the mass of our wretched and filthy bodies. Each of us shall be mother and father to a trillion civilizations. Each of us shall know peace, shall know an end to pain, and shall know Atom in his glory. I urge you, my friend, come, drink with me and pray.
Thank you.
Oh, feeling a bit under the weather? Or a bit over the Geiger counter? I can tell! You're positively glowing! Now, just hold on and try not to move. Tell me how it feels, and I'll get you fixed right up. You're a lucky one, you know. At this level, most people don't make it. But then again, most people don't have my experimental tricks. And now, after taking a few notes, I'll take care of that nasty radiation with a bit of my own homemade concoction. I've never had the chance to test it out on someone so heavily dosed. Oh, but I'm sure it'll work out fine. Exciting, isn't it? Okay, a little Brahmin milk, a couple magnets, and maybe a few happy thoughts. Well, you're alive! Oh, that's the good news. But there was a little side effect. A teeny tiny, mutation. But it seems to be benign, at least. Here, take a few radiation chems, as my little way of saying, I'm sorry I twisted your DNA like a kitten with a ball of yarn. Landmines are one of the few dangers out there that you can profit from. Disarm one before it blows, and you can sell it for plenty of caps. I've heard stories about a ghost town that's just full of mines. Traders just call the place Minefield. Sounds like the place for some field work. Get in there, get back, and tell me all about it. And could you bring back a mine for my studies? Oh, don't worry. No one ever goes there because they say it's a ghost town. And I hear there's a playground in the middle of town. See ya.
Good to see you.
You're looking for. looking for the mayor or the sheriff?
Morning.
How are those hot little potatoes? Because, you know, they're on the ground, like potatoes, and hot because they, explode. Anyway, what's up? My very own landmine! Oh, just what I've always wanted. Well, always since I sent you out on this anyway. Now, tell me all about it. What was it like going through there? What's it like disarming a landmine? Lots of places are nowadays. Good work staying alive in tough conditions. It'll be a great example for the book. I know you may not want to see any more explosives for a while, but obviously you know your way around them. Have a couple rainy day toys of mine. And looking at this landmine, it gives me an idea. It's a terrible device that does terrible things, of course. But it's easy to make your own, too. Yep, you've done a great job. I just need to add in the section on how to cook rat, and this chapter's done. Here, for your services, I've saved up quite a few stim packs. Of course, you may need them. We still've got two more chapters to go. Don't take too long. The sooner the